Here we are again. Day 8. We're doing it. Look at this. I love it. Emily knows her spot. She's ready, raring to go. So let's close our eyes. Start to tune in. Take that moment to become more still. And let's do 3 deep breaths together. Take a big breath in. And letting it go. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. I love the way my guidance works, and I want to explain this to you just for a little bit so you can start to, I don't know if yours works the same, and I just want to talk about this for a little bit because I want you to start thinking about how your guidance works. So I start deep breathing, and it's like, it's literally like a download. It's like, bonk, this is the word, and it just comes right down, and it's like, compassion, there we go. And then there's like this discussion back and forth with all the myriad of entities that I'm in connection with. And there's, you know, well, we okay, yep. And then there's this consensus. That's the feeling of it. It's really great. So compassion, the big mama, right? The big dada takes us home every time. Let's go to our mat. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, stretch to the side. Inhale up. Exhale, stretch to the side. Making circles. You can do a steeple with your hands. Compassion. It's the ultimate. It's the full Monty. In any area of your life that's stuck, that's stagnant, that is not fluid, needs more compassion. Compassion for yourself, compassion for other people. And let's just talk a little bit about compassion, because I feel over the years as I've explored compassion, people sort of see it, they kind of have this, the connotation of it a little bit is that it is a little bit weak and soft, right? Like when we choose compassion, that there's a bit of a weakness to it. That has been the exact opposite of my experience. Let's go into Warrior One. Compassion to me can be so intensely fierce, so intensely tough, meaning that it is the choice. Let's go to Warrior Two. We're going to the heart. It's the choice that again and again, over and over and over, brings us back to our heart. And the reason why I say that it's fierce and that it's tough, or maybe the energy around it can be described that way, is because when we pull it in, right? Like we pull it in like a samurai. We're like, ah, yes, today, my spiritual tool of compassion is here. And when we pull it in, it often can be in moments in which we are wanting to connect in to a softer, more awakened, conscious experience. But we are wanting to do so in a more firm and integrated and direct and intense way. So some of the most compassionate people I know have a real clear, strong connection into boundary, have a real clear connection into the fierceness of love. And so today I open up and I offer to you this definition of compassion, which connects us back into our warrior nature, which connects us back into our power, back into our strength, our solidity, and our grounding. Good. Let's take the legs wide and let's do a big sweep here, side to side. Doesn't that feel good? Just around and around. Good. Oh, it feels so good. So good, so good. Okay. Let's come to the top of our mat. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale to a flat back. And then let's exhale, step it on back into plank pose. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, lower down. So in what areas, in what ways, can you be more compassionate with yourself? How can you harness that beautiful, fierce, grounded power of compassion? It softens you. It broadens you. It reconnects you back into your heart. Let's push back into downward facing dog, pedaling through the feet. Where can you be more compassionate with yourself? For me, I offer this to you because this is sort of my indication of when I need more compassion. Let's come into triangle pose. It's always when I'm wanting to call my mom. On the days when it's like, oh man, I want to talk to my mom. It's always indication. Sometimes, you know, I'm able to connect with my mom, and sometimes I'm able to get that, and sometimes I'm not. And so in the days in which I feel that yearning for that motherly, attentive support, what I do is I really say, okay, wait a minute. I need to be really gentle and compassionate with myself. Because that's what I really look for. That's what I'm really, really yearning for. Let's go to the other side. So in your life, you can start to find all the times in which you, another time too, another time too that I know that I need compassion, and my ego is not always welcoming to, you know, my ego will just be like, kind of like, meh. But it's often when I'll find myself in that sort of, let's say, stuck or defensive mode, you know, like, I'm right. I'm right. They need to know I'm right, right? That's a little voice that my ego loves to have. And so we'll come on up. And whenever that starts going on, it's like, oh yeah. Let's see if I can find, you know, oh yeah. Another, oh, I'll show them. They need to learn. I'm putting my shadow out here. I'm gonna be vulnerable here because hopefully as I do that, it might resonate with you, and it also helps me too, of all parts of myself, which are not light-filled and all beautiful, right? All of us have elements that are dark and embarrassing, or things that we would rather not have come forward, right? But where we're at right now on the love revolution, as Matt Kahn says, love him. Check out his videos if you have not. Other people to check out too. Gabe Salomon, oh my gosh, loving him. Adore Bridget Nielsen. So in love with Gigi Young. These are my peeps on YouTube. So, so thankful for them. Anyway, just take notes of those people. Can't even remember where I was going. Oh yeah, there we are. So, you know, here we are. And on and on YouTube, here we are. So the times in which, you know, and I'm going to do this publicly because I'm just going to practice in front of you, having a sense of compassion for all those moments that my darkness arises within me, right? All the moments that I see it in others, because every single time I'm working with someone, I'm working with myself, of course. And any time that arises, the practice that I find most successful, most helpful, is the practice where I can just let myself hand back to the heart. I can just let myself see that signpost, and it's because my guides will give it to me. When that ego is raging in myself, or when I see it raging in someone else, that first sign is compassion. It's the first sign too that's really helpful when you're feeling attacked, right? Because of course, every single time we're attacked by somebody else, it is always, right, or when you attack someone else. when that attack mode happens, it's always because of something that's happening in your reality, right? And what is the strongest samurai sword spiritual tool we can pull in to soften the whole situation, to align, to reconnect back into our intuition? Compassion, compassion, Not because we're weakening, but because we're strengthening. We're strengthening. Okay, good. Let's come into side plank here. One knee down. We're going to reach on up. I'm just going to keep going back to the heart here. A lot to the heart today, because as you go to the heart, it just helps us remind ourselves that it's okay that we haven't gotten it all figured out. That's okay. And in fact, even in the moment in which you say, it's okay, I haven't figured this all out. It's okay, I don't know where I'm going. It's okay that I'm frustrated or sad or depressed or stuck or whatever is going on, right? Whatever it is, that's when we get in that beautiful, beautiful dose of compassion. Come on in. I mean, that's what's so amazing about being a mother is because, man, I don't know why, but that just like floods in so completely and easily for me. Other side, that flood and well of compassion. And for the areas of my life where it doesn't flood so easily, I pretend sometimes that I'm with my son. And it's like, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. That's how I do it. Cool. So there are arenas in your life where you're really easily connected into compassion, where it's easy for you to identify with that. And right now, let's just for ourselves identify those and celebrate those. Let's just go up. We're doing reverse tabletop here and down, bending through the knees. And just celebrate for yourself. What areas for yourself are you really good at integrating compassion? What are those areas? And just celebrate them right now. Just maybe it's one, or maybe you see a myriad of times. And then let's take the foot up here. Now you can just stay static here and still, or if you want to lift and rise, you can. And as we start to move into the hips, what I want you to do is really begin to identify where would you like to have more compassion. Maybe it's with yourself, maybe it's with others, maybe it's both. But set the intention right now. You can say it out loud. It would be great. I would like to have more compassion in these areas. That's a really important way to connect into your intuition, is to speak it out loud. Speak it out loud, even if it's a whisper. I would like to have more compassion in this area. Let's do two more. And one more. Nice. Good. Let's do a very compassionate move, which I love, which is just rocking the baby here. Take up one leg and just cradle that part of yourself. And so in those moments when I'm like really wanting to talk to my mom, and you know, sometimes I'll call her and she's not home or whatever. And then in those moments, it's like, how can I cradle myself? That's where I go. And those are the most important questions, because that's really the door opening to ourselves. No matter what we've done, we've all done stuff we regret. And all of that is just fuel and the opportunity to love ourselves more, because the truth is, we were doing the best we could at the time. Even if it was our worst, right? Even if it was the most disgusting and gross aspects of who we are, with what we had in those moments, we were truly doing the best we can. And if you can go through life, and if you can witness yourself, and if you can practice that perspective, yesterday we talked a lot about perspective, if you can really start owning that, man, does that give you strength. I go back to so many times people have said to me, but I don't want to be a doormat, and I don't want to be, you know, run over. That's not compassion. Compassion is not getting taken advantage of. Compassion is not staying stuck in the victim mode. Compassion is not letting your ego run the show. Compassion is source connection. Compassion is softness in the highest, highest expression and the highest strength and the highest, highest evolution. That's compassion. So you're in a situation that's difficult. You have compassion for yourself and for the other. And then you do your self-care. And then you do whatever it is that you need to stay strong and to stay vibrant and to stay highly resonant to the best of your ability. That's compassion. Let's just lean back here. I'm going to do this again. We're just going to lean back. I'm opening up through the shoulder area. Great. One leg out. We're just going to lift up, grab onto the toe, and just, you can rock side to side. I'm getting a stretch through the back of my arm. I'm also getting a stretch through the back of my leg. If you can't do this, it's okay. Just reach in the direction towards the foot and do this to the best of your ability. Practice that compassion. What a great arena for compassion yoga is. Oh. I love it. My guides are like, let's do one of your least favorite poses. Ah. All right, here we go. Seems to be a day of going into interesting places. Okay, this is one of my least favorite poses. Hanumanasana, split plow pose. Ah. Bringing the right foot forward, spreading through the toes. You're going to inhale, lift up, and exhale, fold down. Now, you can go as far as you want. What's really fun to explore here, fun. This isn't fun for me. maybe it's fun for you. Hips are going forward, and as we breathe in here, we just bring a lot of compassion into the backs of our legs, into our hips. Oh, yeah. So in other forms, right, the hips kind of splay open here, and we go straight to the earth, maybe. But in the forms of yoga that I've studied, the hips move forward, and we just kind of go as far as we can into that front leg. Now, see, in the poses that we don't like, and maybe you know what those are for you, there's so much there. There's so much there. It's just like the things in our life where we don't want to bring compassion in. It's because, man, is that the medicine that is needed most? Oh, thank you. Okay, let's go to the other side. Keep those hips moving forward. And just breathe into the back of that leg. Whatever's there, you just bring compassion into it. You bring a lot of love, a lot of ease and tenderness. And you practice it, right? That's why I love, obviously, just a slightly partial to this system of asana technique, intuitive yoga, because it's so powerful to align your intention as you breathe and as you move. And that's all we're doing here. We're creating this laboratory to practice in this moment, in this asana, where I don't want to be here. I'll be real with you. I don't like this. As we've talked about before, it's okay not to like things. It's in this arena where it's like, oh, how can I practice? And it's interesting. It was like my whole leg just lengthened. As I just said, I don't like this. I just felt like a letting go in my leg. It's very liberating. It's very freeing to be real with yourself, to have that kind of honesty where it's like, oh, I don't like this. And I could feel it in my leg. There was like a letting go. When we do that in our life, it's so freeing for us to just be like, even if it's like, I don't want to bring compassion here. I don't want to do that. Like, I don't like this. So it's so great about being with my son right now, because you're not sitting there wondering ever how he's feeling, ever. You want to talk about transparency? Just hang out with a three-year-old. It's so freeing. I don't like this. I don't want this. Okay, awesome. Great. Beautiful is that? That raw, beautiful source connection. It's clear. He's not wondering. There's no confusion. It's definite. I would say 100% of the time. Even if he's confused, it's so cool. You can see it. He's like, I don't know. He's clear in that. Such a gift. Such a gift. One more big breath in, and let's come lying on our backs. Bring our knees in towards our chest. And you're just going to roll around here from side to side. Compassion. Good. Let's come into happy baby. Soles of the feet together, rocking side to side. Big breath in. And then lengthening out for Shavasana, letting yourself really relax and let go. You can take the palms, facing them up towards the sky. And we'll just see here what is in the cards for us. Ooh, love it. So the messages for myself and the group that's attracted to this video is that in the particular situations and dynamics where you're most stuck right now and you feel most disconnected from your highest self, set the intention right now that your strategy and your backup plan, got possum here, strategy and a backup plan is what the card is to really be clear with yourself that this skill, this tool and technique of flooding in more compassion is important to set up ahead of time. Meaning, okay, I'm going over to so-and-so's house and I know often that can be really difficult for me. So my strategy here is to remember the spiritual technique of compassion in those moments. Oh, I have to have this business meeting. I have to have this whatever. To envision, to see ahead that this tool and this gift of compassion is there waiting for you to access it. And then to envision yourself calling upon that technique whenever it is that you need it. The second card that I pull is all about freedom and reminding yourself that the reasons why we choose compassion is it's a lot like the energy to me, reminding me of forgiveness. That's very freeing. When you're stuck and you're gripped by your ego, it's the energy of the horse, which is so beautifully freeing and liberating, which allows us to open, to expand, to broaden again, where we can really take on that truth and that principle that what if you viewed the world as if everybody in every moment was with what they had doing the best that they could. How does that free you? How does that free us? The third card is a very specific message. There's at least two people, they're showing me in this group, maybe myself included, that are up for a major, major transformation. Like lifetime, like massive, massive life-changing situation. For these two people, what they're saying that as you're gravitated to this video, you'll know who you are because it just resonates with you. Remember to just stay committed to your truth. And that as you just, in each moment, say to yourself, I am who I am. This is my truth. I am compassionate for myself and others. My only job here is to express my specific and individual truth. So even though that might just be two of us who are up for this massive transformation, the message is for all of us because we all are interchanging with people all the time who are in a constant state of transformation. We have butterfly, that's the third card here. And so it is our job to have compassion for those around us who are in more radical or quick shifting or massive life changes. It's the compassion that will allow our interchanges to be easier with them and the way that we can really love and show up for them. All right, let's begin to deepen our breath. You can start wiggling your fingers and your toes as you reach your arms up above your head and just lengthen out, stretch it out. You can slowly and easily roll on over to your left side, just curling inward. And then easily and gently pressing yourself up to a seated position. Let's bring your hands to heart center. And let's do one om. Take a big breath in. Om. I'm setting the intention that as you move forward into your day, it's that compassionate heart that brings you strength and a quality of grounding, peace, and joy. Have a glorious rest of your day, and I'm so excited to see you tomorrow. Namaste.